Dear students, welcome to the fourth unit of evening metallurgy, that is heat treatment of steels. So today we will start with heat treatment of steels. In unit 3 of evening metallurgy, we have learnt iron carbon phase diagram and various phases which are existing on iron carbon phase diagram. In this slide, I have shown the iron carbon phase diagram, which includes various phases on it, such as alpha phase, that is ferrite, gamma phase, that is austenite, delta phase, that is delta iron or ferrite, and Fe3C, that is cementite. Cementite is also called as iron carbide. And from the figure, it is clear that iron carbon system shows maximum solubility of carbon in iron as 6.67%. Let us start with heat treatment of steels. What is heat treatment? Generally, various metallurgical processes that involves heating and cooling of steels, and generally heating is done in furnace so that the environment is in controlled condition. The heating process should take place slowly in order to minimize the distortion of steels. It is performed to effect structural changes in a material, which in turn affect its mechanical properties. Various heat treatment processes can be applied to steels, such as quenching, annealing, normalizing, tempering, surface hardening, etc. What are the objectives of heat treatment process? Now, in the slide, I have given various objectives of heat treatment process: increasing hardness, wear and abrasion resistance, and cutting ability of steel. Resoften the steel after it has been hardened by other heat treatment or cold working. Adjust its mechanical, physical or chemical properties to obtain desired microstructure. To reduce or eliminate internal residual stresses in steel, as internal stresses lead to premature or brittle failure of the component. To induce controlled residual stresses in steels. To decrease or increase the grain size of steel. To produce special microstructure to increase the machinability and to improve the corrosion resistance of steels. All these or some of these can be the objectives of heat treatment of steels. Let us start with the fundamentals of heat treatment process. It starts with the transformation products of austenite. We know that in iron-iron carbide equilibrium diagram, austenite is a metastable phase which is existing above 727 degrees Celsius. It has been observed through iron-iron carbide equilibrium diagram that austenite does not exist at room temperature conditions. Generally, it gets transformed into different phases based on the cooling rate. Following are the transformations observed during cooling of austenite phase. First one is pearlite, second one is bainite, and third one is martensite. Let us start with transformation of austenite to pearlite. The transformation of austenite to pearlite starts by the formation of cementite nuclei at the austenitic grain boundary. Please see the figure. In the figure, I have shown austenite grain and its grain boundary. This is a schematic representation of pearlite formation by nucleation and growth. In this transformation, the carbon diffuses from surrounding austenite to the cementite and the growth of carbide begins. As carbon diffuses, the adjacent austenite is depleted in carbon and transformed to ferrite. With transformation of ferrite, there is rejection of carbon from the ferrite region. This results in formation of additional nuclei of cementite. Because of alternate formation of cementite and ferrite, the cementite can only grow away from the boundary of the original austenite grain in platelets. Nucleation and growth of alternate plates of cementite and ferrite occurs at several points along the austenite grain boundaries. This forms the pearlite colonies of alternate parallel plates of cementite and ferrite. These pearlite colonies grow until the entire austenite grain has been consumed and become a pearlite structure. So this is shown here in various steps from figure 1 to figure 5. This is the microstructure of pearlite. The microstructure of pearlite includes a white matrix of ferrite, which includes thin plates of cementite, which are black in color. So light phase or white phase is ferrite phase, and dark phase or black phase, that is cementite phase. Let us see the second transformation. Second transformation is transformation of austenite to bainite. So please see the figure in the slide. The figure represents the formation of bainite phase from the austenite. Generally, below the temperature of 500 degrees Celsius, the ferrite nuclei start precipitating at the austenitic grain boundary. General temperature which is considered here is 500 degrees Celsius to 550 degrees Celsius. If the austenite is rapidly cooled below 550 degrees Celsius temperature and held isothermally, the structure or a morphology formed is not a lamellar, but it is a needle-like. Bainite phase is formed in this case. The bainite is an extremely fine mixture of ferrite and cementite. So here this figure shows the microstructure of bainite. There two types of bainitic structure are seen. One is upper bainite, other is lower bainite. Next one is transformation of austenite to martensite. If the austenite is cooled at very fast rate, means athermally, then the morphology or the structure form is known as martensite. The microstructure appears like a rod or needle type, which is generally referred as martensite. Rapid quenching of austenite to the room temperature often results in the formation of martensitic phase. Martensite is a very hard structure in which carbon is in solid solution with austenite. Ideally, martensitic reaction is a diffusionless transformation. The reaction begins at a martensitic start temperature. It is also called as M suffix S, that is MS temperature, to martensitic finish temperature, that is MF temperature. Let us see the another slide here. Here in this slide I have shown martensite start, that is MS temperature, as well as martensite finish, that is MF temperature also. Atomic structure of martensite is also shown, where the carbon atom gets embedded there in iron atom. Martensite is a supersaturated solid solution of carbon in iron, which has a body centered tetragonal structure This structure is in distorted form of BCC ion. Generally, this type of transformation is known as diffusion-less transformation. There will be no opportunity for carbon atom to move or to diffuse out of atomic structure. Hence, the carbon gets entrapped in the atomic structure in the form of BCT, that is body-centered tetragonal structure. Let us see how the microstructure of martensite is seen under the microscope. So next slide. This slide shows us the martensite structure when seen under the microscope. So it shows some rod-like structure in its microstructure. So this is generally known as the martensitic structure. Let us move further. Time temperature transformation diagram or time temperature transformation curve. It is also known as TTT curve. Now, for explaining the TTT curve, I have taken the reference of iron carbon equilibrium diagram also. Steels above Fe and SCM temperature exist in austenitic region. This is very clear from iron carbon diagram. Depending on the cooling rate, that is instantaneous temperature, the different transformation reaction take place. Thus, depending on the cooling rate, austenite may transform into pearlite, bainite or martensite. The relationship of temperature versus time and transformation is thus established for specific composition of steel, and it is represented as time temperature transformation, in short TTT curve. Let us see TTT curve in detail. TTT curve or TTT diagram, it is also known as S curve or C curve or isothermal transformation diagram, is plotted by making use of the various graphs. These graphs are obtained, first of all, the steel, a particular steel is heated to certain temperature such as 700 degrees Celsius, 750 degrees Celsius or 800 degrees Celsius, where 100% pearlite is getting formed and it is obtained there at the room temperature conditions. So percentage of pearlite and time plot is obtained first, and from the same plot points are plotted there on temperature and time graph. All the points obtained on temperature versus time graph are then joined by a smooth curve. The smooth curve obtained is nothing but time temperature transformation diagram. The other figure shows TTT diagram for eutectoid steels. In this figure, the TTT diagram is seen for eutectoid steel, where a term is used, CCR, that is critical cooling rate. So critical cooling rate is also shown in this TTT diagram for eutectoid steel. TTT diagram or time temperature transformation diagram is a plot of temperature versus the logarithm of time for a steel alloy of definite composition. It is used to determine when the transformation begins and ends for a constant temperature heat treatment of a previously austenized alloy. When austenite is cooled slowly to a temperature below the lower critical temperature, the metal structure which is obtained at room temperature is ferrite, pearlite, etc. The microstructure of a metal is significantly altered as the cooling rate increases. We get martensite phase at room temperature if we apply tremendously high, means very high cooling rate. TTT diagram indicates when a specific transformation starts and ends, and it also shows what percentage of transformation of austenite at a particular temperature is achieved. TTT diagram is also known as S curve or C curve or isothermal transformation curve or a diagram. At very high rates of cooling or quenching, a metastable phase called as martensite is formed in steels. TTT diagram is main source of information for the decomposition of austenite under non-equilibrium cooling conditions. In the next slide, I have shown here the TTT diagram for hypoeutectoid steels of carbon percentage 0.3 and TTT diagram for hypereutectoid steel of 1.2% carbon steel. Now let us learn critical cooling rate. Critical cooling rate is the cooling rate which just avoids entering the pearlite and bainite region, that is, it is passing the nodes of, or it bypasses the nodes of TTT curve, or the cooling curve which is there, critical cooling curve which is there, it is just tangential to the nodes of TTT diagram. It can also be defined as the slowest cooling rate which will result in all austenite getting transformed into martensite. Figure shows the critical cooling rate by a hidden line on temperature versus time and transformation curve. See here, cooling rate, if they are higher than critical cooling rate, then complete martensitic transformation is obtained. Hence, final microstructure will be entirely martensite of high hardness. Any cooling rate lower than the critical cooling rate, that is, in short, CCR, will form softer transformation products such as pearlite or bainite. But any cooling rate equal to or faster than CCR will form only martensite structure. So what is the importance of critical cooling rate? Let us see here. It is important for heat treatment of steels. For hardening, the cooling rate must be higher, that is, faster than the critical cooling rate. Critical cooling rate determines the microstructure formed on cooling. Final properties of steel depend on the critical cooling rate. So factors which are there, which are important for critical cooling rate. First one is percentage of carbon content. Composition of carbon in steel affects the TTT curve. For both, that is hypo and hypereutectoid steel, the TTT curve shifts toward left and hence the critical cooling rate increases. Faster cooling rate is required to obtain the martensite. Second point is percentage of alloying elements. Similar to the effect of carbon on TTT curve, alloying elements also cause the TTT curve to shift towards left, except the element like cobalt. Third point is hardening temperature. Higher the hardening temperature, faster the cooling rate is required to obtain the martensitic structure. The next one is continuous cooling transformation diagram, or it is also called as CCT diagram. So here in this figure, I have shown the various transformation diagrams or various transformation curves. This is a CCT diagram or CCT curve. CCT diagram is also similar to that of TTT diagram, but it is having slight differences from TTT diagram. Let us see the difference between TTT diagram and CCT diagram, or TTT curve and CCT curve. TTT curve, the relationship of temperature versus time and transformation obtained under the isothermal cooling is referred as TTT diagram, whereas the relationship of temperature versus time and transformation obtained under continuous cooling is referred as CCT diagram. Second point is, TTT curve is obtained under ideal equilibrium cooling conditions, whereas the practical heat treatment cycle involves continuous cooling of steels. Means CCT curve is obtained by continuous cooling of steel. Third point is, since the cooling is isothermal in case of TTT curve, the curve obtained is an ideal curve. In case of CCT curve, the cooling is continuous, the curve obtained shifts toward the bottom right corner of the diagram. And fourth point is, the transformation is smooth and fast in case of TTT curve, whereas the transformation takes longer time due to shifting of the curve towards the right side. So these are general differences between TTT and CCT curve or diagram.